Place odd Nets hat trick in blowout win versus Penguins 0-3-4. Blackhawks forward Brendan Saad scores hat trick en route to a 101 win over the Penguins. 0-3-4 Emily Kaplan after the morning skate on Thursday, a reporter informed Jonathan Taves that many national pundits have the Blackhawks missing the playoffs. Interesting, the captain said, noting his teammates hardly felt the same way. Maybe we should listen to Captain Sirius more often. Thursday night against the Penguins, Chicago scored 5 goals in the first period, 2 more than they did during their entire 2017 postseason. Pundits' usual concern about the Blackhawks, they're too top-heavy with a roster hamstrung by the contracts of Taves and Patrick Kane. But for anyone skeptical about Chicago trying to get the band back together, it looks like the band could have a few more hits. A hat-trick scoring Brendan Saad was one of many good things about the Blackhawks' blowout victory over the Penguins. Dennis Verzbitsky said today sports Chris Peters on paper, there are certainly holes in this Blackhawks lineup, but offense should not be a problem. Much was made of Kane losing Artemi Panarin as a linemate, but Kane looked just as comfortable alongside Nick Schmaltz and Ryan Hartman. Those three players accounted for 12 points, 5 for Hartman, 4 for Kane and 3 for Schmaltz while skating circles around the bewildered Penguins. 5 points a night won't be the norm, but Kane is going to put up points no matter who he plays with. On top of that, Brendan Saad reintroduced himself to Blackhawks fans after a 2-year run WIHT the Columbus Blue Jackets with a hat trick, bolstering Chicago's top line. Yeah, the Penguins were on the second half of a back-to-back and sure, they started a rusty Antiniemi, who actually stumbled before he even got onto the ice Thursday night, but to get waxed like that it takes a talented team to dismantle the defending champs so completely. Connor McDavid earned the big hardware last season in his second attempt. Can he do it again and will the Penguins pull the unfathomable and three-peat? Our experts have got this. Will the Penguins continue their dynastic run? Will the Blackhawks return to dominance? And just who are the Golden Knights? Exactly, ESPN has the lowdown on every team. Ben Arledge, it is the second day of the season, the Penguins played the previous night and they started their backup goaltender who didn't even post a .900 save percentage last season. Let's not overreact to game 1 of 82, even if it was a 10-goal blitz. With that said, Chicago looks very good to start the season. Kane looked fantastic, stacking the highlight reel all night with 2 gorgeous backhand assists and a ridiculous top-shelf goal, and Saad seems happy to be back in Chittown, finding the back the net 3 times. Early word from Coach Canaville is that Schmaltz is fine after leaving with a right leg injury, which is great news considering how strong he looked. Alex DeBrincat didn't join the scoring party, but I think he's in for a big season, too. The Blackhawks continue to masterfully dance around salary cap troubles in the offseason and stay right in the middle of contention every season. Bottom line is Chicago isn't going anywhere, it was never going anywhere and it will likely take the Central Division yet again this season, but we didn't need to see it run over a team in October to know that. Paul Grant, sure, it's just one game, but the Blackhawks looked great against a Penguins team that was playing its second game in 2 nights, especially in the first period. Off-season returnees Patrick Sharp and Saad both scored, which is huge for the Blackhawks. If those guys can contribute depth scoring like it's 2013, the Western Conference is in trouble.